Welcome back, Random TV Reviews. Your girl Lynette.
And it's your boy Stanley.
What the hell was that?
That's that noise of skid, Mr. Bar.
Well, let's just go ahead and put it like this. Alright. For all of you all that are new to the channel, welcome. Y'all came in on the final chapter of Empire for us. Cause I think I'm giving it up. But before we get there, listen, I put a poll out yesterday on the community board of YouTube and wanted to know if you all wanted us to do a Q&A. We've never did a Q&A on this channel. Of course, we've done them on our vlogging channel, but a lot of you all are not subscribed to that channel.
Yeah.
A lot of y'all are, so I can't say that. But sometimes y'all ask us questions and things like that that most people know from that channel. But if you're just on here just watching our reviews, you don't know the answers to these questions. So we thought it'd be a good idea to, one, see if y'all wanted to know more about us or just a basic Q&A. Ask whatever the fuck you want to ask.
Yeah.
And
I guarantee we're going to answer it all, though.
Yeah.
All depending on what the question is.
So what we're going to do, we're going to do a separate video. And we're going to solicit for those questions. What we're going to do is next week, next Wednesday, which is the 20th, December 20th, we're going to answer those questions live on YouTube. We're going to go YouTube live for the first time as well because we've never done a YouTube live.
Yeah.
I've been meaning to, just ahead of time.
Mm-hmm.
And we did it that way because, one, Empire's gone, so we know we'll be free that night. And we're going to do it at 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, which will be the time that you all will be watching Empire anyway.
Yeah.
And I think a lot of the shows are going off tonight anyway, so I think it'll be a good time to go ahead and do that Q&A. So look out for that video. It's going to be a separate video. We're going to post that tomorrow, and that's going to ask for your questions. And it can be anything. All right, on to this show.
Yeah.
Empire.
Yeah, before we get started, before y'all blast me, I'm going to blast myself. Your boy, your ninja, was wrong. My prediction did not come true.
Your predictions usually be on point,
though. They usually be on point. It just didn't happen this time. I think they changed it up.
Just for you.
So I can be wrong.
Well, you know that happens. You know, they can't let you be great.
But two wrongs don't make a right, because this show tonight wasn't always right.
Mm-hmm. I wasn't impressed. Raise your hand if you were impressed.
Not for a finale.
They could have left last week as the finale, and it would have definitely made all of us come back.
It really didn't give us somewhat good towards the end, the twist at the end.
I won't be impressed with that.
I mean, I ain't say all the way. I said somewhat. All
right, so we're just gonna get into it. So we start off where we see like this, you know, introducing the future king to the throne. Da 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 da, and I'm like, okay, so which one is it? Is it High King or is it Jamal? Oh, it's Andre. Andre comes shaying down the steps,
standing with his gold microphone,
singing Luther Superstar. Long ago, I said, you know what? We are in Andre's head for real.
Yeah, cause I said if we ain't in Andre's head, they done pulled a fast one on us, boy.
Well, come find out, Andre did have a mental break. Like we didn't know that. So Lucius is over at the hospital. Sitting there, he's talking to Andre. The nurse walks in and she pretty much assures Lucius said, listen, everything seems to be stable at this moment, but we're actually flushing his system. So we have him in a seduced coma. It's going to be all right, but at the end of the day, we're not going to know what his brain function is going to be like until all of this is out of his system and we can bring him back around. Lucius said, now let me tell you one thing. My son is going to be all right.
So oh, yeah.
Y'all, rabbit hole. I be knowing that we be full of faith, you know, we be real assured of things when we be in the hospitals with our loved ones and stuff, but we be talking to them nurses like they ain't went to school. Now I know there's a difference between faith, the supernatural, and medicine.
In reality.
That woman just doing her God knowing job.
Exactly.
You ain't got to be all nasty with her talking about what's going to happen. I don't see people go to the hospital and be like, I rebuke you.
Uh-huh.
You don't know
the
what
nurse say
that
something
Lord can
they
do.
Flick oil at them.
The Lord said my mama coming out of this coma in the name of Jesus.
The way I see it is that you need the reality facts so you can have something to put your faith substance on.
Right.
So you need to know what's happening so you can direct your faith in the right situation.
And have it pinpointed.
Exactly. You don't know what the hell is going on with the person, but you got faith that they're going to recover. Recover from what?
Yeah, If that's the case, they would never been up in that.
So I'm like, why did the Lord put the doctor in place if he weren't a part of the plan? But we ain't come to preach. No. Keep the cameras rolling.
All right. So now we get the center around, get the scene to center around a couple of things. We got a going away party for Eddie. Now that Lulu is back, they don't need old Eddie no more.
Yeah, they'll kick Eddie Kane out the group again.
And then we see Diana Dubois over there. She's planning a captain's ball. I said, oh, hell, something about to happen.
Uh-huh, well, something gonna happen.
Miss Diana seemed to be a little shook.
Yes, she's shook.
Because who has briefings with like 20 security guards talking about some... Look, basically, you can have nasty food in the kitchen long as we don't vet it. All of these people
all in here.
Everybody from down to the DJ, they better be loyal to me, and they better not let nail one of them lines come up in here.
Say, Dee Dee, you ain't that ninja that they say you is.
I know.
Yeah, you're supposed to be hard in these streets.
Sitting over there scared.
Scared to death.
And I said, did Cookie turn Councilman Tay Diggs into an alcoholic? Every time I see him, he got some brown liquor in his hand. Just over there, just strung out.
But she got him stressed out.
Butt hurt. That's what happened.
Yeah,
butt hurt. So we're over there at the party over there for Eddie. Now, we know that Cookie is not convinced that Lucius is back.
Nah,
you know, we still have a little delayed Lucius going on every now and then. So she's
he's still buffering.
He's still buffering. No, Wi-Fi not clicking on. So she tells Eddie, she was like, Eddie, I don't know if he's back. So Eddie said, well, let's go ahead and see. You know, I'm going to go ahead and test the fool. Hey, boy, you ain't about that life. Oh, so I'm not. And he gets on the piano, which you know that's where Lucius resides. So he started singing. And, of course, Lucius went ahead and joined in. So Eddie is kind of convinced that, okay, if he ain't 100%, maybe he 95.
Yeah.
So that gives Cookie a little bit more reassurance that, okay, if I go down and if I can't take care of this family, maybe the Papa Lion can. So we end with that. We didn't end with that. We see Becky get sick at the sight and the smell of shrimp. I said, that wench pregnant.
Yep. I bet she pregnant by, what's that rapper name? God, I can't even think of his name right now. Was it Papa? Papa?
Yeah.
Papa
something.
Papa something. Papa was a Rolling Stone.
Yeah.
Yeah, that dude.
J. Popper,
yeah.
That's his name.
Yeah.
Well, Thursday had rolled up on Becky, and she was crying. And he said, what's going on? Your hormones out of whack? She slapped her skin.
I don't want to hear nothing about no hormones. Pow!
Thursday said, you know what? Who's the proud daddy? It's all right, baby girl. I know you ain't even made it. Gave her the handkerchief for that. I said, Thursday, you better than me. You is better than me.
Shoot, what was Thursday, baby?
Oh God.
Cause it was a little bit sweet on each other. Cause you know, she helped him with a little bit of connection to get that job in the A&R.
And he liked the big girls now.
Uh-huh. Big girls. You better back it up.
Remember that elevator scene?
Yeah.
So we see Cookie, Lucius, the boys, and Thurston. They're basically talking about how they're going to get into the captain's ball.
Mm-hmm.
Now that we don't sit Eddie on his way, now we got a mission that we need to accomplish. We need to get in there and do what we got to do. Now they thinking, and they talked to Thurston. Thurston got everything checked out. Thurston said, hey.
Thurston's a bad, I don't care what y'all say about Thurston. That's a bad man right there.
He said their security is tighter than the Virgin. You ain't getting up in there.
Nah.
He said, I don't know what you got to do or how we going to do it. So they're thinking of different plans of how they can do this. Do they know this person?
Cookie said, this is a family meeting. It'd be nice if you chime in. He said, ain't nobody asked me for my opinion yet.
He said, when y'all rattle my cages, when I know you want me. So, Lucia said, listen, we're lions. We don't do all of this rigmarole and this, and doing the shoots and ladders. We do music.
We get into the music. How are you going to do that? You just going to walk in the door just singing?
What the hell you gonna do? You gonna do what God's trying to tell me something?
Yeah.
I mean, how are we gonna do this, Lucius? So we see Lucius and Cookie. They're in the car. And Lucius goes to...
he went way out left field.
And he started basically talking about his thing.
Yeah, his prosthetic leg that nobody don't think that he can get down to bed anymore because he got a prosthetic leg. Do he have sex with a leg on, a leg off? And
do you rub my nub or not?
Yeah, like, what?
What and she
what,
said.
What?
Cookie said, listen, Lucius. Right now, I ain't got no time to be thinking about what you can and what you can't do in the bed. All I need to know is that you're back. Point blank period. And I'm not really comfortable and reassured that you really are back. So at the end of the day, you say vengeance is yours, but they came after me. Yeah. So the vengeance is really mine. Yeah. So if you feel like you want to be able to back me up and do whatever you got to do, then we got one shot.
I'm here for it. Yep.
And let's go ahead and take this one shot. Next thing we know, we see Councilman Tay Diggs trying to get into his car to go over there to the captain's ball. And who's sitting in the back of the car? Lucius and Cookie's security guard.
Yep.
Then Lucius rolling behind him. He said, oh, not so fast.
Get on there. I said, what kind of security? Y'all supposed to be the tight flight security of the world, Craig.
See, they didn't have him.
They didn't have him because somebody would have been right there with him to make sure he wouldn't have got kidnapped.
And Cookie drive. So they don't took him down there.
But you know, I think about it, you know, Dee Dee don't give a fuck about him at this point.
What's the next step?
Dee Dee.
So they took him down to Chinatown. And Lucius actually took control of
the old situation. Lucius came back in this one right here.
And he told him, he said, listen, I need you to sign these documents to say that your mother kidnapped Bella Lyon. That's what I'm going to need you to do.
Yeah.
Councilman Tay Diggs stepped in Lucius and was like, listen, I ain't gonna do a mama thing.
And smacked the goddamn clipboard out of his hand. So I think he thought it was still the old Lucius when he smacked the clipboard out of his hand. Like, wrong move, player.
Lucius said, listen, we got something in common. Both of us got crazy A mamas that got controlling A personalities.
Mm-hmm.
Casper Tate Diggs looked at him and said, the only thing we got in common is that B in the truck that both of us don't smash.
I said, oh, player.
Next thing we know, Lucius already took out the gun and put the silencer on. And next thing I know, he did a whoop that trick.
Three pieces of the jaw.
I said, okay, now Councilman Tay Diggs is looking like Cousin Warren. Now look like twinning.
Yeah.
He went on signing the paper, said, don't get no blood.
Don't split no blood on the paper there,
you
player.
You know, because the judge going to think this is a little ironic that you signed off on something, but it's bloody. These are bloody shoes.
I bet you he had an extra copy on there, though.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Like, yeah, you know, sign this copy right here.
So next thing we know, they back into the vehicle. And we over there at the captain's bar. Over at the captain's bar, everybody going through security. Lucius. It's trying to get through the security. They said, oh, Mr. Lyon, we can't let you up in here.
But why they didn't recognize him until they scanned his leg,
though? Until they scanned his leg. For real.
What kind of security is that? Face recognition. Even the computers can do that. Y'all supposed to know what it looked like.
They did that in Vegas to cook it.
So you shouldn't even had to scan him. When you seen him walk in the door, somebody would have been right there to stop him.
Well, Councilman Tate did say, you know, it's all right. They with me. And everybody looking at him like.
They was like, no, we have strict order. And he said, nah, it's good.
What the fuck going on with your face, dude? I'm good. I just need them to come on and go in here with me.
I had to slip and fall and stuff.
But before then, Jamal got a goddamn visit from Mr. Warren himself. And how did he end up in Jamal's apartment? He paid the goddamn doorman $10,000. I said, it's time for you to get another
fired,
doorman.
If you for sale, you supposed to be the doorman? Huh?
So Jamal tells him,
I don't know if I was doorman. I would have probably took that money, too.
I would have took it. Let me stop. I'm just playing. I'm one of them loyal people.
I ain't playing.
You stupid. So,
Card out here for a pimp, too?
The pimps and the imps, too. Jamal said, listen. What you need to do is go ahead and turn your happy hind paws, busted eye, busted lip tail, back away from my house because you knew what your daggone auntie was doing to my brother and he could have died.
Yeah.
Matter of fact, he's still holding on, you know, hanging on to life right now. And you sat in my face and in my bed and never once breathed a word to me about what was going on with my family. And he said, you know what, but I came over here to give you some information. Jamal was getting ready to let him go.
I said, you better not let him go.
And at the last minute, he said, oh, before you leave, what was it you came over here to tell me? And then I say, okay, he gonna give up all the details.
Yeah.
Which I was happy about. So over on the inside of the captain's ball, Miss Diana Dubois, she notices that the lions are in the place, in the building. She calls for security and Casamente did. She said,
got this on lock. Don't even cause no scene.
Don't cause no scene. They in here deep. They even in here through the music.
Yep.
And the next
whole
thing we
orchestra
know,
up there.
Next thing we know, the music change. And it turned to this, to basically the opera and all that.
They started dancing.
Yeah, Cookie and Lucia started doing a little 1-2, 1-2, doing what they do. Got a little semi-applause from the crowd. And the next thing we know, introducing, da-da-da-da-da. Then we see Jamal and Hakeem jump on stage.
Yeah, the trap song.
And Cookie said, oh, you didn't know that the hood know how to play classical music as well.
Yeah.
Okay, we're real burst around here. So before they start performing, Jamal said, oh, remember me from last year? The People's Ball? Well, not really the People's Ball.
Captain Ball, a lot has changed, you know, a little bit. No shade.
You know, my brother Andre would have been here, but, you know, Diana Dubois tried to kill him.
Yeah.
I said, God, do it. So then Hakeem used to run in his mouth, you know, da-da-da. He's trying to kidnap my baby Bella.
Mm-hmm.
I said, okay, y'all just shady y'all one. Then they went ahead and performed, and I will be honest, I like the song.
Yeah, that opera Rihanna with that joint, that trap song.
You get trap music and God doing and
with live orchestra, live. It's over with, man.
I'm trying to tell you, y'all know what y'all missing with y'all doing that.
Telling you, man.
They perform, and now it's Cookie's show. Cookie gets up there, grabs the mic, and she basically tells the crowd, listen,
everything.
Y'all think that she's an upstanding citizen of this community, a pillar in your community, they do this and do that. Oh, she's trying to kill my baby. You see her family right there? You can't even rub shoulders without bumping into somebody that she has under her control.
Yep.
That one right there, she got that good doctor over there to up my baby's medicine and mess him up, make him start hallucinating. Mm-hmm. This lady, she did that.
I think they gave Andre Love Boat. Cause Love Boat that skit back in the day to make you freaking see stuff that ain't even there.
No, Love Boat freeze your hind parts up. Make you feel like you ain't breathing. Don't ask
that too. That too, but you be hallucinating.
You ever smoked it?
Nah, I heard about it though.
Well, yo, you can't talk to somebody that has. I'm just saying. I didn't do it on purpose.
Yeah, I don't know though. You sure about that?
It wasn't on purpose. Somebody tried to get me, they tried to kill me. Y'all could ask that question in the Q&A too, if y'all
want to. Yeah, about the Love Boat, yeah.
But anyway, so Cookie gets up there and she was like, listen, kidnap my baby. You know, this one right here, she got her nephew to act like he was in love with my baby over here. Broke his heart, ripped his heart out. Mm-hmm. So the whole crowd is looking at Diana like,
Who is this girl? Who is this lady?
And she said, Diddy. I said, you know what? So then they were like, you know what? We even have proof of the stuff that we're talking about. And up comes Malcolm on the big screen. And Malcolm pretty much talked about the Bella thing.
Yep.
But what we did not know, because Hakeem had went on up there, and because Anika was getting ready to run with Bella.
Mm-hmm. He had his paperwork.
Told Anika, listen, go ahead and sign over your rights to this baby so that she can go back in my custody. She was like, no, I'm not going to do that.
Mm-hmm.
He said, go ahead and do it because I have a videotape of you and Ms. Dubois having a meeting. You're an accessory.
That Warren gave us.
Yeah, Warren told us where it was at.
Yep.
You're an accessory to kidnapping. And she cried and she signed the papers.
Dear,
and he said, but you know,
don't take her from me.
This is what I did love about this scene. Hakeem said, listen, I'm not going to do you like you tried to do me.
Mm-hmm.
I know how it is not having my mom in my life growing up. So you can be in Bella's life, but all of this tit for tat and
trying
we're not
to use her
doing
against
this,
us? Nah, that stops today.
That stops today. And don't forget, statute of limitations ain't never over for a kidnapping.
Man,
so
sure ain't.
Pull something and I got you by the
You going back to jail. Cause she was like, I don't want to go back to jail.
She had got
said,
no flashback.
He says, I need papers,
she
buddy.
Said, and now listen, Lord, I love how baby Bella just she just all up on Hakeem. You can tell that they really do care for her all, you know, all on set.
Yeah.
And she's so comfortable with them. Mm-hmm. So I was like, okay, Hakeem, you get props for that one. He told Anika, he said, what you don't want to do is go downstairs. He said, because it's a red wind down there. We know Cookie just went off. She was just going on, telling all the business. Up until the point where she said, Miss Dee Dee, you ain't nothing but a common criminal.
Yup.
Dee Dee walked towards her and said, you and your family ain't never going to be good enough to judge me. And y'all in here that's hooing and hawing and backing away from me, I made some of y'all too. So this ain't what you want. And the police are on the way to get this Miss Cookie Lyon off of the stage. But when the police get there, she think they're going for Cookie. She said, oh, there she is right there, arrest her. They said, oh, no, we here for you. And the kidnapping of Miss Bella Lyon.
Yep.
I said, well, God don't.
Got her.
Got her high paws. But at that time, Councilman Tay Diggs had already slipped out, told her, said, listen, I'm going to go ahead and find that Warren.
Yeah.
And I'm going to take care of him for doing what he just did.
So I'm going to take care of that straight up.
Yeah, and I'm going to put him down. Well, he found it.
I don't know how in the hell he found him at Motel 8.
Motel 6.
Yeah, Motel 6.
Four and a half.
How in the hell did he find him? Only on TV.
Found him, pulled a gun out on him, told him he was going to kill him. At the same time, Jamal walked in behind Councilman Tay Diggs. So now, there's this strange stick-up situation going on. Yeah. He got a gun just going like this. He don't know which one he going to get first. Well, he ended up popping his nephew, his cousin.
Cousin Warren.
Shot him somewhere up in there. We thought it was the chest, but it seemed like it was the arm.
Got him in
the
arm, yeah.
Well, at this time, Jamal said, hey, you know, he a lion. You shoot him, I'm probably going to be next.
I'm tussling with you.
So they had a little tussle and whatnot. And eventually, they both got pinned up against the wall. We couldn't see where the gun was at, but we eventually heard it go off. Both of them looked like they could have been shot.
Mm-hmm.
But it ended up being Councilman Tay Diggs. And he looked dead as a motherfucker.
Mm-hmm. Say, when you lay down and your eyes don't shut,
him gone.
You either in a coma or you dead.
Well, he ended up calling 911 saying that, you know.
Somebody
and he disguised his voice a little bit.
It's like somebody been shot.
Somebody been shot. And he, you know, and
I think they dead.
I said, you may have messed up on that one.
He might even run. He might take one and run.
They might run, but at the same time, if your dad on GPS will pick you up over there at the ham. I mean, over there at that hotel. We don't know how that's going to go.
Mm-mm.
So, and they say we know. What else? I'm going to make sure I ain't losing nothing. Oh, so, yeah,
Lucius goes to see,
Lulu goes to see, Andre. Because he wants to put it in Andre's spirit that, hey, I took care of that for you.
Yeah.
What they did to you, they ain't getting away with it. I got this. Your daddy is here. And he told him to say, listen. Daddy is back, and I'm going to need you to come back stronger than ever. Because I'm Lucius Plus, I'm going to need you to be Andre Plus.
So I ain't 1.0, I'm Lucius 2.0 now.
So I said, okay, that's all cute and whatnot. But before Lucius had got there, Mr. Shine had found out where they were hiding Andre.
He trying to do damage control.
He talking about something. You been keeping your mouth shut? Nah, I don't think you been keeping your mouth shut. And he went like he was about to do something to Andre. Like he was about to put him out. Like that guy doing Eddie tried to do other thing on If Love You Was Wrong.
Yeah.
Then Lucius walked in. He was like, Shine. Hey. Oh, we good girlfriends now. So we are. So Lucius kind of had that look in his eyes like.
Something ain't right about this.
But yeah. Right now I'm not going to deal with you.
Yeah.
Okay. But he put it in Andre's spirit that, you know, it's all taken care of. Andre starts to come around. And when he came around. You know how when you first get out of jail, you go straight into confessional. You know, you start trying to right your wrongs. You get right with the Lord, get right with your mama now because you need somewhere to stay. You know, all that good stuff. You get right with your baby mama because you know you don't want her to put you on child support right away.
Yeah.
Well, Andre decided he needed to get right with his father. He told his father, said, listen, that bomb, I tried to kill you. I tried to kill you.
And Lucy was like,
huh? And then somebody tried to kill him.
So they put him in there. Said, what? Who is that?
And they said, we know Cookie wakes up in the middle of the night.
Yeah.
He never came home.
See, Cookie was planning on giving him some cookies that night, you know.
Yeah, because
she remember what he said in the truck.
That he was like, still getting
I'm gonna see if you can back that up.
Mm-hmm. Get in here with your one leg. Back it up. And in the meantime, in between time, we see over there at Empire, Eddie is over there taking his last stroll with some young little tenderoni, getting his R. Kelly on. And his ex-wife, what's her name? Giselle?
Giselle.
She comes rolling up. And she was like, have you heard? Have you heard? And he was like, what you talking about?
I said, Lawrence.
Well, Eddie evidently got hung up in a financial scheme.
Yeah, Ponzi scheme.
Yeah. Now he's broke. And she's scared.
I done been in plenty of them.
Yes.
From knives to vacuum cleaners to selling Christmas toys. Y'all can ask all about that in the Kings. You want to know about all of that?
Too much. Too much to talk about. Well, he looked around and he said, you know what? Don't even worry about it. I'll take care of it. Because do you know where I'm standing at right now? Basically, I'm standing in money right now.
Yeah, so, and you know, and he don't want me to go nowhere, so.
All I got to do is stay around a little bit, and I say, you better not.
You better not try to scam them.
Scam or steal from them in their most vulnerable moment. You bet not. Mm-hmm. But at the same time, I don't know what Lucius may have done to you in the past, too. So
yeah,
I can't
judge.
Yeah,
might have got you, yeah.
So I can't judge you just yet, you know, but. That was basically it. So it seems like next season when it comes back on, we're going to have a whole scene from, what's the movie where the girl stole the baby? Where she's supposed to have been the surrogate for the baby? And she stole the baby from Morris Chestnut and all them?
It's right on the tip of my tongue.
Well, it's a combination between
it's
that
something
movie.
Not ease by her.
When the bow breaks.
When the bow breaks. Yes.
So we're going to have that whole thing going on where Claudia, she wants Dwight so bad.
She done stole him.
That she done had a fatal attraction, an obsession.
Did she have him chained to a chain like a rock wall?
Yes. Yes. Well, he is a dog, but she had him chained up and everything. I said, what you gonna do now? Break his ankles next? So then we see Cookie. She goes over there, and then that's gonna be next season. I don't think I'm gonna be here next season to review this. I need to pray about it. Let me tell you this.
Yeah.
I'm not gonna tell you 100% that I quit, just like I did if Love You Is Wrong. I told y'all without a
now. If Lucius is truly back and he not buffering anymore,
he's
I might
still
come
buffering.
Back.
But we won't know until we start, and I don't want to start and not stop because
I mean episode one should well. Whatever season it's gonna be, I can't even remember right now. The first episode will probably let us know, but then that could fool us.
We started off
the first
this one.
Uh-huh. Yeah, it first one real funny. Be like, ha ha ha. By the time you get to three, like, what is this buzz kid?
So I don't know. I gotta pray about it, y'all. Pray for me.
So I don't.
Yeah.
I don't know. But yeah, don't forget to look out for the video tomorrow for the question and answers.
And we'll see you all next. Well, I don't know. We'll see you on something. Just come on back over here. We'll be over here for something. Straight from the VA.
The dirty, dirty South.
Two up, two down.
Holla. Holla.